Once you have an eBay account up and running, you can start listing and selling items that belong to you. With the options available on the online shopping website, ranging from auctions to selling from one person to another directly. Welcome to another episode of Global Banking Finance Review. My name is Deepika Lobo. Today we're going to talk about how to start selling on eBay. Let's have a look at the salient points that you should be aware of when you start selling on the e-commerce site and why many prefer it. Set up an eBay account. The first step to selling on eBay is setting up a personal account if you intend to sell secondhand items. While a business account is ideal if you want to resell items such as clothing, using your Facebook or Google account during the setup is ideal as it shortens the process, but you have to ensure that your account has a catchy username which attracts attention. Make a listing with tools or Shopify. Once your account on eBay is active, you can create listings for products that you want to sell. To ensure that your account and products get the most attention, you can use tools such as Quick Listing and Advanced Listing that eBay has. You can also opt to use the Shopify store to add new products, and once this is synced with the eBay sales channel, the listings are automatically created. The e-commerce site also has a hub for sellers, which allows you to easily manage the selling tools that you use. Choose a pricing strategy. Compared to other e-commerce sites such as Amazon, eBay prices can vary dramatically. The reason for this extreme variance is that an eBay seller can price an item higher if it's not available anywhere else. Additionally, eBay is famous for its auctions in which vintage baseball cards and other collectibles such as comics fetch millions of dollars. So you can choose to tag an item with a fixed price or create a listing with the auction option. Choosing a payment method. When you set up an account on eBay and use it for selling, you will have to pay a certain amount of seller fees. You pay fees using several options, including PayPal, credit card, or check. Setting up shipping and getting paid for items sold. There are several tools which eBay provides to help sellers set up shipping options. Among these options is one which allows buyers to pick up the item in person if you live in the city. There is also a drop shipping option, and buyers can also calculate shipping costs. Buyers can also opt to pay for items via PayPal, credit or debit card, or when they pick up the item. Getting feedback from buyers and effectively managing and dealing with complaints is a step that no eBay seller can ignore. Also, it's recommended that sellers set up and adopt a process to deal with items that are returned by customers or those that go missing, and also provide refunds as per eBay rules and policies when needed. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. And one lucky winner will win a 1-year free subscription of Global Banking Finance Review Magazine.